As president of ASN, it is indeed an honor to have the privilege of introducing the Honorable U.S. Representative Jim McGovern. Congressman McGovern has long been a strong and passionate advocate for nutrition and food security since he was first elected to Congress in 1996. His career is focused on ending hunger, and he, especially in children, and he actively works to protect and support domestic and international child nutrition programs. He's responsible for developing the McGovern Dole International Food for Education and Child Nutrition Program, and that provides nutritious meals to nearly 9 million of the world's poorest children and supports education, child development, and nutrition security. Congressman McGovern also introduced the Healthy Breakfast Help Kids Learn Act of 2017 in the House of Representatives to expand student access to the National School Breakfast Program. I look forward to hearing more about the important work of the Congressman, such as his founding of the Food is Medicine Working Group, in his remarks. Thank you, Representative McGovern.
Hi, everybody. Thank you so much for inviting me to join you for this year's annual conference. I'm Congressman Jim McGovern. I proudly represent the 2nd Congressional District of Massachusetts in the United States House of Representatives. I also serve on the House Agriculture Committee, serve as the chair of the Congressional Hunger Center, chair of the Congressional Hunger Caucus, and co-founded the Food is Medicine Working Group here in the United States Congress. I want to say right off the bat that I'm deeply grateful to the American Society for Nutrition for putting together this incredible conference, but also to all of you participating today from around the world who are focused on breaking down the barriers between healthcare, nutrition, medicine, and technology to create a healthier world. I'm here today to talk to you about hunger and food insecurity, a devastating reality that far, far too many families deal with every single day. You know, by now we're all familiar with modern day bread lines stretching miles down the road and shelves stripped clean at food banks following the COVID-19 economic collapse. But the reality is that even before the pandemic, here in America, we had a hunger problem. On any given day in 2019, an estimated 35 million people, including 11 million children, experienced some form of food insecurity. I and others in Congress have tried to step up to help blunt the impact on struggling and food insecure families. We fought to increase government nutrition assistance for struggling families, ensure that school children had continued access to nutritious lunches while learning at home, and successfully prevented harmful regulatory changes proposed by the previous presidential administration that would have drastically curtailed SNAP eligibility. And so many others have stepped up too, from nonprofits to food banks to school nutrition professionals who have kept our children healthy and learning. But despite our best efforts, more families than at any other time in recent history have experienced hunger during the pandemic. You know, it does not have to be this way. I always remind people that hunger is a policy failure. It's a political condition, not an inevitable reality that exists because of a lack of food. We have the food. We have the resources, and we have the know-how to actually end hunger in America. Hunger is a solvable problem. What we lack is the political will and a plan to get there. For example, we know that food is medicine. Hunger not only means that people do not have enough food to eat, it also means that the kinds of food families eat are not nutritious enough to sustain a healthy and active lifestyle. Now, this can be because families live in food deserts and aren't able to easily procure fresh, healthy food. It can be because it's often cheaper to eat food that's not so good for you. It can be because there's a lack of resources and awareness out there about how to eat healthy. It can be because the school their children go to doesn't have the funds or facilities to produce nutritious food. Yet, despite all of this, we have no nationwide plan that recognizes this critical link between hunger, nutrition, and healthcare, even though the research is crystal clear. Food insecurity can lead to chronic diseases like hypertension, coronary heart disease, hepatitis, stroke, cancer, asthma, diabetes, and arthritis. 1 in 3 patients who enter into the hospital are malnourished. Those patients have hospital stays that are 3 times longer, and their inpatient costs are 3 times higher. In fact, just in my home state of Massachusetts alone, hunger costs at least $2.4 billion a year in health-related expenditures alone due to poor health, pulmonary disease, diabetes, mental health, obesity, and more. So if we view food as medicine, not only can we alleviate a whole lot of suffering, but we can also save our healthcare system billions of dollars each year. Now that's why I'm joined together with my colleagues to launch a bipartisan Congressional Food as Medicine Working Group, because we can no longer afford to look at hunger and healthcare as separate issues. They're two sides of the same coin. When families don't have access to nutritious food, their health suffers, and by extension, our country suffers. It's as simple as that. So working together with groups like the Food as Medicine Coalition, the Center for Health Law and Policy Innovation at Harvard Law School, and the Tufts Friedman School of Nutrition, Science, and Policy, we have been holding briefings and meetings for members of Congress and their staff to share innovative solutions that can make a real difference as we seek to address the connection between food and medicine. And just in the last few years, I've noticed a change in thinking around this issue. More and more people are coming around to the idea that food is medicine and that nutrition is healthcare. That change in thinking is one of the main reasons why I've been working with the White House to encourage them to hold a substantive policy-based conference focused on ending hunger by 2030. Now is the time for us to think creatively, outside the box, and to bring the full weight of the entire United States federal government to bear on addressing this challenge. The first, last, and only White House conference on nutrition and hunger was held 52 years ago in 1969. Now that conference was far from perfect, but it was responsible for the creation and expansion of vital anti-hunger safety net programs like the Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program, the Special Supplemental Nutrition Program for Women, Infants, and Children, and the National School Lunch Program, all integral parts of our national food security strategy. 52 years later, I believe that now is the time to think holistically and improve our coordination across this array of social service programs, bringing into focus both the successes and especially the failures of the federal programs. Who's falling through the cracks? What more needs to be done? These are questions we need to address, maybe with some new solutions. Now, one thing that has been made clear during this pandemic is the need for federal programs beyond nutrition assistance to provide an adequate safety net. Unemployment benefits, housing, affordable child care, health care, and tax credits are critical supports for families under stress. Together, these programs and policies all help address hunger. The problem, though, is that they span across many programs and agencies and levels of government. Imagine the progress that could be achieved today if the heads of food banks, hospitals, government agencies, nonprofits, educators, and faith-based community all had a seat at the table and worked together with the White House to solve our hunger crisis in a holistic way. They could develop a real plan with actionable benchmarks to help us end the hunger crisis by 2030, as the United Nations has called for. And I personally believe that this conference should improve on the 1969 conference in one key way. It should include a diverse group of Americans who have experienced hunger firsthand. Such perspective is vital to ensuring our policies are centered on the real experiences of everyday people, not just numbers and statistics. Another challenge of addressing this crisis is that there is no one committee in Congress that's tasked with solving the hunger problem in America. Because of that, we often have these silos that get built up, preventing us from seeing the big picture. Now, luckily, I'm the chairman of the House Rules Committee as well. And because my committee is not constrained by those jurisdictional issues, we can do whatever we want. We can hold hearings on anything we want. So I've begun a series of nationwide anti-hunger hearings, roundtables, meetings, press conferences, and visits to uplift a diverse chorus of voices so that when the Biden administration is ready to hold a hunger conference, they can hit the ground running with ideas and feedback readily available to help shape the dialogue. I encourage you to visit rules.house.gov to share your thoughts on nutrition security and hunger in America. You know, my firsthand involvement in the movement to end food security began way back when I was a student interning for Senator George McGovern, no relation, great last name. In the mid-1960s, or I should say late 1960s, a documentary called Hunger in America ran on CBS. Like scores of other Americans, my old boss sat with his family and watched. Senator McGovern's first thought was, why are they looking into hunger in the United States of America? Now, many Americans believed hunger to be the problem of other countries, not ours. But as he watched, Senator McGovern saw a little boy tell the interviewer that he had no food at school and was regularly hungry. The interviewer asked the little boy how it made him feel to watch other kids eat while he went without. And the little boy said he was ashamed. That night, Senator McGovern sat thinking about what he saw. And he told his family, you know, it's not that little boy who should be ashamed. It's George McGovern, a United States Senator, a member of the Committee on Agriculture. George McGovern teamed up in a bipartisan way with Senator Bob Dole to launch a special select committee on nutrition and human needs. Their actions paved the way for the first White House conference and decades of progress on the issue of hunger. Yet more than 50 years on, despite all that we have learned, hunger persists. And I'll say it, it's still not that little boy or millions of people who face hunger today who should be ashamed. I'm ashamed. We all should be ashamed. The time has come for the promise of this nation to be that no person goes hungry in America. And that's what I'm working toward. That's why I'm calling for this White House conference, because patchworks and Band-Aids, it's not enough. It doesn't work. I have seen how hunger makes it harder to learn, harder to grow, harder to work, and harder to take care of our kids. For all the good that the government does today, it is clearly not enough. In fact, the progress that my old boss and mentor, Senator McGovern, and others fought so hard for has been heading in the wrong direction. But still, I'm hopeful. I'm hopeful because of the work that all of you are doing to bridge the gaps and to break down the barriers that prevent us from taking action on this issue. And I'm hopeful because I think ending hunger is within reach. It's not only the right thing to do, it's the smart thing to do. It's no small task, but there was a time when the sky was literally the limit, when we thought big. Well, the same year we held the first White House conference on hunger, we put a man on the moon. Then we reached for the stars. Science connected the world, mapped the genome, and set out to eradicate disease and famine. Just last month, NASA flew a helicopter on Mars. That's the kind of bold thinking we need to build a nation and a world that is hunger-free. So when people tell me that they're, you know, ready to go back to normal now that the pandemic is over, I tell them normal wasn't good enough. We got to do better. And I believe that it means that, you know, that every single person living in this country and in this world deserves the basic human right to wake up each day without having to worry about where the next meal is going to come from. We have the food, the knowledge, and the resources to guarantee nutrition security for every human being. So let us begin. And with your help, together we can build the political will to recognize that food is medicine, to call for a White House conference on hunger and nutrition, and we can and to end hunger once and for all. And so I look forward to working with all of you to turn plans into action and action into results. You know, I'm tired of managing hunger. I'm tired of the disconnects between making sure people get access to food and nutrition. We can tie it all together. And so please join me in this effort. Again, thank you and stay safe.